What's up, y'all? This your host, Corey Ashley, coming at you live from the Press for Conversation podcast, episode 4. Today's topic is very interesting. It's going to be about black entrepreneurship. Black entrepreneurship is a great thing. It's a great thing to own something and value something. And I want to get into this topic because this topic is a hot topic. And today, when I got on here today, I read about an article about a guy named Justin Trudeau. For y'all out there that don't know Justin Trudeau is a prime minister Canadian from Canada. Today, Mr. Justin Trudeau announced that he's going to give out $221 million business loan programs for black entrepreneurs. He's going to throw one. A $221 million business loan program for black entrepreneurs. Dealing with the racism and the police brutality, that's a great thing. And I got so much respect for him because he's willing to put more into the black community. You know what I'm saying? He's doing actually more for the blacks than our president at the moment. You know what I'm saying? He's really a good prime example coming from a different race and culture. Justin Trudeau is a really caring person. For him to want to put $221 million business loans programs for the black entrepreneurship during this pandemic, I love it. The black community, we just have to stick together. We just have to stick together and come together on a lot of things. And us black people are so intelligent and so unique at a lot of things. You know, we just have to just sit down and stick together and figure it out. But black entrepreneurship is very unique. It's a lot of black entrepreneurs I look up to. One of them is Tyler Perry, Nick Cannon, Master P. Who else black entrepreneurs? There's a lot of black entrepreneurs. A lot of black entrepreneurs out there I look up to, but them the ones I follow on a regular basis. Tyler Perry, Nick Cannon, Master P, and Jay-Z. It's a few of them. It's a lot of entrepreneurs that's out there that own businesses, you know. But I want to become a successful black entrepreneur someday, and I will. I will become a successful black entrepreneur, but so can you, and you will if you decide to chase your dreams and don't let nobody tell you what you can and can't be. But being a black entrepreneur is not bad. It's great for the black community because us as black people as a whole, we need to learn how to own something and value something at the same time and giving back to the community. You know, we can spend money on a $500 or $300 pair of shoes. We can put $300 or $500 in the savings bonds or stock marketing to build ourselves up as a great entrepreneur. I'm learning how to be a black entrepreneur right now. I don't know much about black entrepreneurship. That's why I'm glad I'm talking about this topic today. But I just want to say this. It is a great thing that this prime minister from Canada is willing to put $221 million into a loan program for black entrepreneurship. That is a great thing. And kudos to that prime minister for that, you know, Mr. Justin T. You know, so I just want to get on here and say, just keep going. Keep following your path. Keep going. Shoot for the stars. Don't be afraid to fail because everybody done failed before. You know, that's part of becoming an entrepreneur. You're going to reach failures before you reach success. But it's a lot of black entrepreneurs that's successful, you know. And I just want to learn the tips. I want to learn the tips so I can be able to give my give back, you know, give back to the community or whatnot. So, like I said, just stay above float. Find you a business that you love and enjoy, and go for your passion. And you never know, your passion one day might be your paycheck. And that's entrepreneurship. And you can be able to have a successful business to put other people on and have people chasing their goals or help somebody building their brand and building their product. So for y'all down here that are listening to this video, subscribe down below and hope to hear from you soon.